Hey, it's Kaylee. We already know a lot about inequalities, but did you know we can graph inequalities? It's true. Let's learn how to do it. Now, let's say we have an inequality like x is greater than 5. What types of values for x are a solution to this inequality? Is x equals 3 a solution? Nope, 3 is less than 5. Is x equals 5 a solution? Nope, x is equal to 5, but this inequality only has solutions that are greater than 5. Like x equals 6. That's a solution. And so is x equals 100. And even x equals 5.1. In fact, we could say every value of x that is greater than 5 is a solution. Now, that's a lot of solutions to write down. So instead, we can use a picture or a graph to represent our solutions. We do this on a number line. Now, we want to plot every number that is greater than 5 on this number line. Does that mean I start at 6? No way. Then we would miss all those numbers between 5 and 6 that are greater than 5. So instead, we go to 5 and we draw a circle. This open circle means starting at 5 but not including 5. And then I draw a line with an arrow at the end. And the arrow means that this line keeps going to infinity because every single number that is greater than 5 is a solution. And that's it. We plotted our solutions. Now let's try plotting this one. Our inequality says x is less than or equal to 7. So what type of solutions will I have? Yeah, that's right. Every value of x that is smaller than the number 7. But because this says less than or equal to, does that mean 7 is a solution? It sure does. When x is equal to 7, the inequality is true. So how would I plot this inequality? That's right, we'll use a number line, and I'm going to start at 7 and draw a circle. But remember, what does an open circle mean? Yeah, an open circle means that the number is not a part of the solution. But 7 is a part of our solution. So to show that 7 is included, all we have to do is fill in the circle. So filling in the circle means that my number is included in the solution. Easy, right? And now I want to include all of the numbers that are less than 7. So what direction should my arrow point? Yeah, my arrow should point towards 0 and include all of the negative numbers. And that's it. We've plotted the solutions to the inequality x is less than or equal to 7. For our last example, let's match the inequalities in the left box with the correct graph in the right box. So how should we get started? Well, let's take a look at our inequalities. This one says x is greater than or equal to 4, y is less than 4, and z is less than or equal to 4. So all of my numbers here have a 4, and all my graphs look like that they have a circle at the 4. Okay, so let's start with this first one. X is greater than or equal to 4, so we know the circle will be at 4. And this symbol here, greater or equal to, does that mean I have an open circle? Nope, it means I have a filled in circle, right? So I'm looking for a graph that has a filled in circle at the number 4, and I want the values to be greater than 4. So that means my arrow will be pointing towards the bigger numbers, right? So it'll look something like that. Now, how about this one? Y is less than 4. So this symbol means open circle or closed circle? Open circle. And y is less than 4, so I have my circle, my open circle at 4, and I want all the values that are less than 4, so what direction will my arrow point? Yeah, my arrow will point towards the smaller numbers, so towards 0 and all of the negative numbers. Now for this one, z is less than or equal to 4. This symbol here, open or closed circle? closed circle. Anytime I have an or equal to, I'm including my number in the solution. So I have that circle at 4, and z is less than or equal to. So that means what direction is my arrow pointing? Yeah, towards 0, the numbers that are less than 4. So it's going to look something like that. Okay, so now we have a rough idea of what our graph should look like for each of these. So for this one, I'm looking for a closed circle at 4 that's going towards the bigger numbers, the greater than. So it looks like this one has a closed circle at 4, but it's going towards the smaller numbers. So that's not right. How about this one? 4, closed circle, towards the bigger numbers, right? So this is the graph for this one. How about here? Open circle towards smaller numbers. This one, open circle going towards smaller numbers. So this one must go here. And that means Z must go with this one, but let's double check. I want a closed circle at 4. Got it. And Z is less than. So it's going all the way towards 0 and including all the negative numbers. So this one goes up here with this one. Perfect. We did it. Great work plotting inequalities. Are you ready to practice on your own? You've got this. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey.